And welcome to another lawnfawn video. Today we are so excited to be introducing you to our brand new die heart pouch. This heart pouch die makes this really cool three-dimensional treat holder, and it also has a really great heart pouch dotted hearts add-on that gives a fun detail to it, and we'll show you a different way to use that dotted add-on in just a little bit. We're also going to give you a peek at our new washi too. But first we're going to take a look at all of the pieces that the heart pouch has. It has the heart pouch, of course, this really cute XOXO tag, a fun little detail that you can put on the sides of your heart pouch, and a cute little bow and an individual heart that you can decorate with too. And here we have the heart pouch dotted hearts add-on. And this is a cute little dotted detail that you can add onto your heart pouch. So all you need to do is just center it right there in the heart shape of the heart pouch, hold it in place with some low tack tape, and then you'll run it through the die cut machine and look at that gorgeous dotted detail. So it leads the dotted detail, but it doesn't cut anything. You can also add this dotted detail to other projects too, and we have a cute card at the end of the video. We'll show you how to do that. Now it's time to put the heart pouch together, and you can see that the die has these little score lines on it that are going to add the score lines that you're going to fold on your heart pouch. And so we're going to start folding along all of those lines. You'll see that there's these little diagonal lines that you're going to fold on right there. And you'll repeat the same thing on the other side. Then once you have those diagonal lines folded, you can continue to fold on the rest of the score lines in the heart pouch. So you'll see that there's one right along the heart shape, and then there's two that are going to create little tabs on the sides. After I'm done folding along all of those score lines, I like to take a bone folder and just go right over all of those folds to give them a nice sharp crease, because that's going to make my box look really finished at the end. Then the next step is to fold the second heart piece, because you're going to die cut two of these hearts to form your pouch. So we're just going to fold along all of the score lines, the diagonal ones, the horizontal and vertical ones, and then we'll take a bone folder and reinforce those all so that they have a nice sharp crease. Now that we have our two heart pieces folded, we are actually going to be cutting off that small tab on one of the hearts, only on one of them. And it doesn't matter which one, because in the end you won't be able to tell. You'll see when we put it together, but we're just going to snip off that tab just like that, and you'll see that our other heart still has that small tab. Then our next step is to add some nice strong double-sided tape. So this is 1/4-inch tape here, and we're going to add it along both of those long tabs, and then we'll add it to the short tab that's been left on one of the hearts. Now, to put these together, I always like to pick up the pieces and kind of see how this heart pouch is going to form. So there you can kind of see how it's going to form. And then what I do is I just kind of open it up to see how they're going to connect. And this is how it's going to look. So you'll see that there's almost like this kind of flat horizontal edge to the hearts, and they're kind of pointed off to the side, and it's going to line up just like that. So I'm going to peel up the liner paper and then line those hearts right up, making sure that those horizontal score lines are all kind of lined up with each other, and I'm going to tuck that tab underneath. And then once I have that in perfect placement, I can press down and secure the heart pouch so that now it's all one piece. Then forming the rest of the heart pouch is really easy, because you'll kind of see it almost kind of form itself. And so all we need to do now is peel up the liner paper on the other two tabs, and then we're just going to form the box, lining up the tabs and adhering them to the inside of the box. The small tab will attach right there at the point of the heart, and then the long tab is going to attach the rest of the box together. And then you'll see that you have this really great little pouch that's perfect for adding little treats to the inside. And then there's all of these little holes there, and that's how we're going to end up tying this whole box together. So I'm going to take out some lawn trimmings twine here, and we're going to start feeding the twine through all of the holes in the heart pouch. And so I always like to start from the back of the heart pouch, and I'm just going to go through that one hole. Then I'm going to go through the two holes there that are on that kind of the piece that had those diagonal folds that we did, and then I'm just going to go up the hole in the front of the box. And then I'm going to repeat that with the other end of the twine on the other side of the box. So I'm going to go up through the back, and then it's going to go through the two holes on the piece where we folded those diagonal folds, and then it's going to go up through that front hole, and that's going to bring the whole thing together. Then all you need to do is tie a little bow or a knot, and your whole heart pouch will be formed. I'll just trim off any of the excess on my bow. And I just think this is just the cutest thing, even out of this plain craft cardstock. It's just the sweetest little heart pouch. I just adore it. And to open it, it's so easy because all you need to do is just untie the bow, and then whatever treats that you put inside, you'll be able to dump right out and eat. So I just think this is just so sweet and so adorable for Valentine's Day. Now, next up, I wanted to take a look at the three new washi tapes in this release. We have our So Mush Love washi tape, we have our Diagonal Rainbow Stripes foiled washi tape, and our Happy Mail foiled washi tape. And these designs are so cute. The little mushrooms just make me so happy. They are just so adorable, and they are perfect for all of those adorable porcupine and happy mushroom cards. The next, we have our Diagonal Rainbow Stripes foiled washi. The foil on this is so gorgeous. It's like this beautiful rainbow foil. It's just so pretty, and it adds the best pizzazz to your envelopes or to your card designs. Oh my goodness, look at all that shine. It is just so pretty and so fun. And then last but not least, we have one of my favorite washi's ever, which is this adorable Happy Mail foiled washi. Look at this. How cute is this going to be on your envelopes? I love the cute foil detail. I love the little hearts on the envelope and how one of them has Happy Mail 123 Smile Street. I mean, oh my goodness, that is just so cute. And the pastel rainbow is just so gorgeous. And so here's a look at those three washi tapes and the beautiful foil on them. Oh my gosh, it's just stunning. And next up, I wanted to show you some really cute cards by the design team using the washi tape. Here, Yanea layered the washi tape one on top of the other to create almost like her own custom pattern paper, and that beautiful foil, oh my goodness, it's so gorgeous with the sending big hug sentiment. And then Elise had a similar idea with the Diagonal Rainbow Stripes foil. She lined up all of those beautiful rainbow stripes to create her own pattern paper and then die cut a little heart-shaped window in it for the sweetest card ever. Now we're going to take a look at some of the other elements in the heart pouch, and we are going to be creating this really cute XOXO tag that's included in the pouch, and it has the main base piece that's the tag shape, and then you layer on the XOXO letters, and this little tag is so cute on the pouch or really any Valentine's gift that you might be giving. It even has that cute little reinforcer tag that you can layer over the top or not. And then here we have the heart pouch cut out of some of the fruit salad paper. This pink gingham, I think, is one of the cutest things for this heart pouch. And we're going to start creating a heart pouch with this adorable pattern paper. And just like we did before, we're folding along all of the score lines on the heart pouch and then just reinforcing them with the bone folder to give them a nice sharp crease. Then we're going to go ahead and just trim off that extra little tab on one of our pieces. Then we'll add our 1/4-inch double-sided tape to the long tab and then also the little short tab on the one piece, and then just on the long tab on the other piece since we trimmed off the short tab already. Then we can peel up the liner paper on all of those adhesive pieces and we can start to form our box. And to form the box, first we're going to line up the two pieces so that those horizontal score lines are lined up, and we're going to tuck the tab under and press down. Then we can pick up the box and you can start to see how it forms. We're going to attach the tiny tab at the bottom and then that long tab there on the side, and that's going to form our heart-shaped pouch. Then we're going to add this cute little lacy detail. This comes in the heart pouch die, and I think these are so adorable, and it really gives that kind of like traditional Valentine's feel. And these are perfectly sized to go on the side of your box. So you just layer it right there in the center, and isn't that just so cute? I just love these. I just think they're adorable. And then so I like to take this one and just layer it with the one I've already added so that it looks nice and continuous, almost like it was like a little vintage lace ribbon or something going around your box. Then the next thing that we need to do is add a little tag. And so we're going to be adding our XOXO tag, and we're also going to be adding the cute little bow that is included in this. And to do this, it's nice to take like the edge of a pencil or a paintbrush like this and then just round the cardstock around it. That's going to help give your bow a really cute rounded shape. Then we're going to add some adhesive to those little tabs that are at the ends of the bows. And you're going to go ahead and fold those in so that they meet in the middle of the bow. So you'll see it's just going to meet right in the center there, and that's going to give your little bow shape. And I think this tiny little bow is just the cutest thing. So we're going to adhere that there, and then we're going to adhere that. We did this with tape runner here. You can also do it with liquid glue, and we'll do that in just a little bit later on in the video. Then there's a little tab that sticks out the bottom. We'll add adhesive to that, and then you just wrap that around, and that's going to give you your finished bow look. And then I just like to hold it and kind of secure it, make sure the whole thing kind of gets really nicely adhered together. And then you can start to work on the little tails for the bow. So there's two ways to do this. You could layer the bow right over top and make it more like a little bow tie like this. Or that little long piece that's going to go behind the bow also has a little fold that you can do in the center. So what you'll do is you'll fold along it in the center, and that's going to create the little diagonal bow ends that can hang down. So you can do the bow either way. And in this case, we're going to do those little diagonal bow ends because those are just so cute. And then we'll just adhere this whole thing together, and then you can see how adorable it looks on the box. You can layer it kind of right over where the twine comes out, and I just think that is such a sweet look. It's just such a sweet little Valentine thing. And you can layer all these different things. So you could add the bow and the tag or just the tag. And of course, you can fill this with little treats. So these are those Dove heart chocolates that are perfect for Valentine's Day. I also think conversation hearts would be really cute inside of the pouch. And so we're going to add those on there, and then we're going to be adding the twine just like we did before, where you're going to feed it through the back of the box, then it's going to go through the holes there on the little diagonal piece and then through the front, and then you'll repeat it on the other side. Once you have the twine securing the box closed, you can go ahead and tie a knot. And in this case, we're going to tie a double knot so that we can then add the little XOXO tag onto there. So we'll tie that second knot, and then you can feed it through the tag. And I just think this is just the cutest look. You can then tie a little bow or get creative with however you want to put your whole box together. And so then we can just trim off any of the excess on the twine, and look how sweet this is. Oh my goodness, I can't wait to make a bunch of these for Valentine's Day. Now we wanted to show you another tag idea. So here is our Magic Heart Messages stamp set. We're going to use the Happy Valentine's Day heart, and we're going to stamp that out in some wild rose ink to coordinate with that really pretty fruit salad paper that we used for our heart pouch. Then we can take the coordinating die for the Magic Heart Messages and line that up. We'll hold that in place with some low tack tape, and then we can run it through the die cut machine, and it's going to give us this really pretty stitched heart detail around that Happy Valentine's Day message. And then here I have a little hole punch, and we're just going to line up that hole punch there, kind of in the center there at the point of the heart, and we can just punch a hole, and now that could be the tag on our heart box. So I like that there's a lot of different ways to decorate these cute little heart pouches. I love the idea of keeping it simple and die cutting these heart pouches from pattern paper, because the pattern paper just makes it so beautiful. But I also love the idea of decorating these heart pouches, and we're going to do that with a cute critter scene. So we're going to be die cutting our heart pouch from some white cardstock so that we can do some stenciling. So here we have our grassy stencil, and we're going to be stenciling some grass at the bottom of the heart pouch. But before we do that, we're actually going to take some post-it note tape, or you could even just use a normal post-it, and we're just going to layer right over that part that has those diagonal score lines, just to make sure that we don't get the grass on that edge of the box. And then we're just going to ink with some freshly cut grass ink right over the stencil and on to the heart pouch. And this is a really fun way to add some decoration to the box. I love this grassy stencil because not only does it have the stencil, but it has the mask too, and that's what the top part of the stencil is. So we're going to line that up over our grass to protect it so that we can start to create some stencils with the cloudy stencil. So we're going to make sure we cover up the rest of that kind of diagonal part of the heart pouch to make sure we don't get any of our inking there. And then we're going to take the cloudy stencil and line this up, and we're going to create a cloudy sky over the rest of the heart. So we're going to be using some merman ink, and we'll start on the stencil and then move on off the stencil onto the heart pouch. And when you lift up the stencil, you'll see that there's going to be this beautiful cloud shape. Then the cloudy stencil has all these different shapes on each side of it. So we're going to turn it, shift it down, and then add some more clouds onto the heart pouch. And then just do it again. And this is one of my favorite stencils ever because the clouds are just so pretty. So we're just going to keep moving on down this heart pouch and creating this beautiful cloudy sky. Then we can remove that post-it tape that we are using as a mask on that kind of diagonal part of the heart pouch, and we can start to work on our scene. So we're going to be using the Porcupine For You stamp set. These little guys are just so cute and sweet, and we're going to be creating a little scene where the big porcupine is going to boop the nose of the little porcupine, and I just think this is so adorable. And it's much easier to form the scene when this box is flat, so that's why we're doing this way, also so that we can add some stamping too. So you'll see when we add this little guy, look, he's going to boop his nose. It's so cute. And then we're just going to layer in some of those mushrooms there to kind of help fill in our scene. And I really like the pop of red too. I just think it's so fun and really perfect for Valentine's Day. The Porcupine For You stamp set has all of these cute tiny little phrases, and we're going to use the one that says boop, and we're going to stamp it right above this little scene. It's so fun for kind of adding that kind of adorable little element that's just going to make someone smile by stamping in the cute little phrases. And this is just so sweet. Then we're also going to be taking out a speech bubble from the Happy Village stamp set, but a ton of our stamp sets have speech bubbles in them, so we'll just shop our stash and find a speech bubble, and then we're going to stamp another one of those little phrases, which is the Happy Valentine's Day one, and we're going to stamp that in some red ink to go along with our red mushrooms. Then we can just use a light blue marker to add a little bit of detail right around the speech bubble just to make it look kind of three-dimensional. And we can die cut that with the coordinating die. And now we'll have this perfect little Happy Valentine's Day that we can add on to the heart pouch. Now that we've added all of our decoration, we can take out our second plain heart pouch piece, and we're going to start to fold along all the score lines just like we did earlier in the video, on both the diagonal ones and the horizontal and vertical ones, and we're going to do that on both of the heart pouch shapes. Then we're going to take the bone folder and reinforce all of those scores so that they have a nice sharp crease, which will give it a beautiful finished look. Then on one of them, we're going to trim off that little tiny tab just on one of them. And we're going to add our quarter-inch double-sided tape to the long tabs and then the short tab on the other box. So three pieces of tape total. Then we can peel up the liner paper on all of those pieces of tape, and then we'll start working to connect these pieces. And the best way to do that is to look at that long score line, make sure it's nice and horizontal, and line those up, and you'll tuck the tab underneath and press down. Then as you lift the box, you'll almost feel the box start to form, and you can attach the small tab at the point of the heart and then the long tab to complete the whole thing. And now you can see how cute this is to have this adorable little box all finished. For a cute little finishing touch, we're going to add a little butterfly into the sky there to kind of balance out the scene. And then, of course, we can add some of our lawn trimmings twine. And so we're just going to trim off a piece of that. And just like we've done before, we're going to feed it through the back of the box, through the folded ends there, those diagonal folded ends, and then through to the front of the box. Then we'll repeat the same thing on the other side. So we'll feed it through the back of the box, through this little piece there, and then up through towards the front of the box. And that's going to help secure our whole pouch in place. Then we can go ahead and tie a knot and a little bow. And I just love this lawn trimmings on there. I love that it's got the pink and the red and the white, and the red kind of goes along with our sentiment and also with those cute little mushrooms. And then we can just trim off any of the excess. And this pouch is almost all done. But at this point was when we realized, oops, we forgot to stencil the grass on the other side of the box, so right here. But the good thing is it's actually really easy to stencil it right onto the form box. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to take our stencil, just kind of look at the side there and see how high up the grass is going to go. And we're just going to put that over there and just actually hold it in place and ink on right to the box, just like that. And it seems so silly, but it's actually really, really easy to do. And now we'll have that nice continuous pattern. The other thing you could have done would have been to stencil both of the pieces at the beginning, and then you would have had the grass going all of the way around. But that's okay. I love finding those moments where we can still make it work and make it look awesome, even if we've already formed our little pouch. And so our last little finishing touch, we're just going to take that merman ink that we use for the clouds, and we're just going to add a little bit there just so it just kind of matches. You don't need to use a stencil. It's just going to kind of coordinate a little bit better with the side of the box. And this little heart pouch turned out so cute. And we wanted to show you another one that we created too that has the little hugging porcupine. So I love that you can take this similar look and kind of create different little scenes with your favorite stamp set. And next up, Shari is going to create a super cute heart pouch. So take it away, Shari.
So I'm recreating a little heart pouch that was created by Yainea. I'm starting by cutting my heart pouch out of kraft cardstock, and then I'm adding the dotted detail to both sides of this pouch. I love how this dotted heart detail looks on this heart pouch. Once I have that detail added to both sides, I'm going to fold on the score lines that the die creates. And I will fold both of these pieces exactly the same. So I'm folding at the heart, the two tabs, and then I will fold in on this score line right here. And then for the other two, I want to fold them towards me to create a little V shape. This is going to be how the heart closes. They're going to line up with the holes, and that's where we'll put our string to tie it closed. So I'll do the same thing to the other piece so that it is folded in the same way. So once I have both of them folded in the same way, I can add some double-sided adhesive tape to the tab. So we have the little tab and then the long tab. And we're actually going to cut off one of those little tabs. So you'll see I'm going to trim this off here. And that's just because both of the little tabs end up in the same position. Now I can peel off the liner paper and line this up and fold that little tab over so they're connected right there at the base. And actually, I didn't get it stuck very well. And I found that it was a little easier to see from this side versus the back side. I could see my folds and line them up a little bit better. Then I can pull off the liner tape for those long tabs, and those just go on the back side of each heart. And now my little box is created. Before I tie this together though, I wanted to add the little details. So I'm using the little stitched heart that also comes in this die set. I've cut that from some mermaid cardstock, and then I'm just grabbing a stamp out of Porcupine For You so I can stamp the word your on this little heart. So I'm just selectively inking up just the word your, and I'll stamp that on to the little heart. Then I will be cutting a sentiment banner from some Ballet Slipper cardstock using that really wide banner here. And I'll actually be trimming it down to be a little bit shorter because I'm using the Scripty Sweet die to layer on top of it. And you can see there it's just a little bit longer than I want it to be. So I'll just line this back up and trim off the end of that sentiment banner so I have a bit shorter one. And then for the Scripty Sweet, I'm cutting it from some fruit salad cardstock with that really fun pink plaid. I'll just add a little bit of liquid glue to the back of it, and I can layer this right onto that little banner that I created. Now I can add this to my heart with some liquid glue, just going right across the heart there, and I like how it overhangs the edges. And then I'll add the little heart that says yours so that the whole thing says your sweet. Yainea made a couple other ones, so you'll have to check out her hearts to see the other sentiments that she created. Now I've got some peppermint lawn trimmings twine, and I'm just going to cut a long piece of this. Now I did discover that the easiest way to thread this through is to go ahead and line up the holes and pinch it and hold it in place and thread this through all the holes at once. And I'm just trimming off a little frayed end there because I tried threading it through the hole one too many times. Now that I've got it through both holes, I can just pull these to be the same length, and I'll just tie these in a little bow. And this will hold your little treat box closed until you give it to the recipient. Then I can just trim off the excess length of my little twine here, and then this is ready to go. And this is a perfect little pouch for little treats or little candies for Valentine's Day. I love that sweet little heart dotted detail in the background, and I added it to the back side as well, so we have that detail on both sides. Thank you, Yainea, for letting us recreate your cute little heart pouch today.
I love this little pouch so much, and the dotted detail on both sides is just so sweet. And next, we wanted to show you that you can use that dotted detailing die actually just on a card, not even always just on the heart pouch. So we're going to die cut some Ballet Slippers cardstock with the largest of the outside in stitched rectangles. And then we're going to take out that dotted add-on there that's for the heart pouch, but we're going to be using it on a card. So we're just going to kind of line that up on the card, hold it in place with some tape, and we can run it through the die cut machine. And now you'll see that we have that beautiful little heart detail. Then what we're going to do is we're going to go back to that heart pouch, and we're going to use the bow in that little heart pouch to be able to decorate this cute little heart and make it almost look like it's a little hanging heart. So we're going to die cut that from some of this favorite flannel paper, and that pinky red color of the favorite flannel is perfect for Valentine's Day. And we're going to take this little bow, and just like we did before, we're going to use the edge of anything you can find, a paintbrush, that was a little pokey tool, just to kind of curve the paper a little bit. It'll just make your bow feel really special. And then we're going to add a little drop of glue right in the center, and we're going to connect those two little pieces of the bow and just hold them right there in that drop of glue. We can add one more drop of glue there so that we can go ahead and take the other side of the bow and put that down. And then what I like to do at this point is I like to use my tweezers to hold everything in place and make sure that that glue dries really well. Then once that glue dries, we can go ahead and take the little end that's sticking out and wrap that around. And then once again, we can use our tweezers to hold that in place and let it dry so that it's nice and secure. While that's drying, we can work on the little tab end there. So you can keep those little bow ends straight, or you can fold them in half at kind of like at a diagonal. You'll see there's a little score line there for you to do that. And that little diagonal just is just so sweet. And so we're going to be adding some glue on the inside of the diagonal to help hold that in place. And then we'll add a little bit more glue at the top of that. We can layer the bow on and then once again use our tweezers to hold everything in place so that it dries nice and secure. Next, this cute and simple card needs a happy Valentine's Day sentiment. So we're going to go to an oldie but a goodie that's one of my favorite sentiment sets, and that is the Celebration Scripty Sentiments, and we're going to use the Happy Valentine's Day, and we're going to be stamping that in some raspberry ink that's going to coordinate really nicely with that favorite flannel paper. So we'll ink that up here in our Misty, and we're going to stamp that right onto this Ballet Slippers cardstock, and I really like all of these shades of pink for Valentine's Day. Now we want the bow to be kind of hanging off the edge of the cardstock. So here's just a piece of that favorite flannel paper again, and we're just gonna trim off a little piece that's like an eighth of an inch wide, just a thin little strip. And this will be able to be our little piece that our bow is gonna hang from. And you can see that we're layering that little strip right into that part of the dotted heart that's kind of open, because that's in the heart pouch. That's where the openings where you put the twine is through. But what we're going to do is add a paper bow there instead of a twine bow. But this could be really cute with twine or actual ribbon as well. And this is just looking so sweet. And so now we're going to take a standard size card base, 5.5 by 4.25. We can layer that same favorite flannel paper that's going to coordinate with our bow onto the card base, and then just add some foam squares to the back of this panel just to give a little extra interest with a little pop. And then we can layer this on. And this is a really quick and simple card that just packs a big punch because it just feels so special with the dotted details and that three-dimensional paper bow. And now we're going to take a look at some amazing pouches and cards by the design team. And these pouches by Yanea are the ones that inspired us to make ours today. They are so super cute. I love that she added the dotted detail to the pattern paper. It looks so pretty on that fruit salad gingham, and how she added these big scripty words on there that gives such a great detail. I also love the dotted hearts on the plain kraft cardstock too. These are just so much fun. Here, Callie was inspired to create a cute little scene using the All My Heart mouse, and I love the gold foil XOXO tag. And then these by Grace, oh my goodness, she used our stitched mountain dies to create the look of chocolate-covered strawberries on this heart. This is just the cutest thing I have ever seen. I mean, oh my goodness, how sweet is this? And I cannot wait to make little pouches just like this. It would be such a cute gift to give along with chocolate-covered strawberries. I absolutely love the pastel colors that Elena used by using our Spiffier Speckles paper. The gold splatters on them make the heart pouches look so special. And then here, Melissa blew me away by stitching around that dotted heart detail on a card. I just think this is so gorgeous. Here, Maureen used our winter bird stamp set in a fun Valentine's theme that I think is so pretty, especially with that beautiful vellum sentiment that says love you lots over top. And then here you can see that you can add a little inking to some cardstock to really make that dotted heart shine, and that little three-dimensional bow on the pouch looks so sweet. I just love the bright and happy colors that Leticia used and how she used a real piece of ribbon through the heart pouch. It looks so cute. And then here are those beautiful washi tape cards that I showed you towards the beginning of the video. I love the idea of layering washi tape onto cards to create some beautiful custom pattern paper that has this really great foil detail. So we cannot wait to see all of your heart pouches and all of the cute ways you use the new washi tape, so make sure to share it with us. Thank you so much for watching today, and I hope you have an absolutely amazing day. Bye!